What's that?
Unscheduled interruption. So if you find this, you're walking around the Institute campus, mm-hmm. let's say, maybe this is actually some scholar's work.
Yes, absolutely.
So what do you do then?
did click on those things, what did it bring you to? Like, visit here or fill this form?
So is any information shared just by clicking the link itself?
Absolutely.
Or do you have to go to the next step of actually logging in?
When does this come up? I just got this for the first time this morning. No, I didn't.
Right.
I was just doing internet research. To the second choice in my Google search,
mm-hmm.
and it took me right to where. So
sure.
It was a good warning.
Yeah.
I have a question.
Yes.
I was curious, when I ever get anything like this,
mm-hmm.
I always forward it to help desk. Is that?
I just want to add a little something to what Brian is saying. I was the executive that tried to get phished. This was interesting because, you know, I work for Robert. And so when Robert asks me to do something, typically I do it as fast as possible. Like, I don't like to leave my boss waiting for something. And so I got an email that said,
can you make sure that this particular account gets this funding? You know, and it was pretty specific. It was, you know, like it looked like this could have been a grant or agency or something that Robert wanted to support or something that the Institute would support, et cetera. And I read it, and it was signed Robert, two B's, right? So it was specifically addressed to me as the chief operating officer for something for my boss and asked me to send, you know, this wire to this particular funder, which would be something that I would do for Robert. But I didn't remember Robert ever mentioning this funder. So I walked, he was in that day, and I thought, first I was like, you know, my instant reaction whenever Robert sends me an email is I hop on it right away, right? And then I was like, I don't remember him ever mentioning this to me, and typically when something like this comes up, he mentions it. And he was in his office, so I walked over and I said, do we have anything to do with such and such? I got this weird email asking me for XYZ. You know, is this something that one of our faculty is interested in? Is this something that I should be funding or whatever? And he was like, I didn't send that to you. Mm-hmm. What did it say? And so I sent it. So then, of course, I didn't send it to Fish. I sent it right to Brian, which is what I what I typically do. But so it was very specifically focused to me.
That's right.
In my position from my supervisor. So somebody took some serious time to say, this is somebody who might do this type of a process. So just kind of keep that in mind. It may not always look like generic. It might be something that comes directly, looks like it's to you.
Absolutely.
It looks legit.
Thank you for sharing.
just ask a question about the quarantine digest? So I don't actually get an email saying you have a quarantine digest. Am I supposed to be looking for it somewhere else? So if you're actually sending emails and you don't realize you're sending more than 50 in an hour, mm-hmm. Do you notify us in any
sure.
way? Thank you. But you won't send 60 messages and never hear that the last 10 were never.
So are there spaces in between?
Yep.
Oh.
Yep.
Huh.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time, even if they would never say those things. So, for instance, they could have me say things like, Killmonger was right. or Ben Carson is in the sunken place, or how about this, simply, President Trump is a total and complete dipshit. Now, you see, I would never say these things, at least not in a public address, but someone else would. Someone like Jordan Peele. This is a dangerous time. Moving forward, we need to be more vigilant with what we trust from the internet. That's a time when we need to rely on trusted news sources. It may sound basic, but how we move forward in the age of information is going to be the difference between whether we survive or whether we become some kind of fucked up dystopia. Thank you. And stay woke, bitches.
have a question.
Yes.
So the what is, I'm not asking this because I'm thinking of going into business on this, but what are the penalties for, how has the law progressed to penalize people for doing things like doctoring the ATM machine or phishing in this way and stealing people's data?
Sure. So
you don't hear a lot about that. I'm just very curious.
A little bit different. Like I was searching for different 1042s tax form,
yes.
Right on the internet, and you know you go on the site and it looks good and all, it looks professional, and it says click here for a demo. I'm like, you know, I mean, you talk about the paranoid thing. I mean, and especially since you know you get sent out the emails, like I ain't gonna do that. But you know, it could be real. But how do you?
Yeah, but can I just add one more thing, Brian?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, just to that, the other thing that I would do in that situation is pick up the phone and call that company. If it's a legitimate business, I wouldn't email them necessarily, right? Because the email could go wherever. But I would pick up the phone, call the phone number on their website, and get a sense from talking to that person. Did this sound like a real business, or do I sound like I interrupted somebody in their kitchen, and I'm not going to download this demo? But, you know, again, talk to them and do some, you know, personal vetting of, did this feel like a real business? Did they answer the phone like a business? Did they transfer me to the sales department? Like all those things that you would expect to happen.
Well, I think we.
Yeah, I know. Right.
We're going to stick with what we have.
Great.
How confident should we feel about using Viper on our home computers? Yeah, I've noticed once in a while it tells me that my Viper is out of date, and then I check it, and then it says everything's up to date. It's kind of confusing, but
yeah,
I've done it numerous times since I got it on the home thing, gone through, gotten a new key, and reinstalled it.
Okay.
It just gives you a little sense of insecurity when you get that message.
Mm-hmm.
I just updated it a month ago, and now it's telling me it's out of date. Or not.
Something that's happening lately that's increasing the number of phish attempts over the last couple of weeks? Because in the last 2 weeks alone, I think our office has gone up. I've sent at least 4 to you guys in the last
right.
week, and even our phones in the director's office are going nuts.
And again, but if they're successful on the first attempt, we're guaranteed to see a second, a third, and a fourth come very quickly. So like last week, there was a first attempt, and once it was successful, we knew there would be some follow-on to that. I mean, so that's part of it as well.
So an example that happened this morning, somebody
sent...
the one
I sent you,
yes.
Marty, because you just responded to
yep.
it.
So what happens, once they get the credentials for a user, they might even scrape the directory of the institute and get everybody's contact information.
Absolutely.
I just got an email addressed to Dr. Martin Van Winkle.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure a lot of you got that. It had links to go to a conference. The conference didn't have a login page or anything like that, but the conference, from what I can tell, is completely... illegitimate. It doesn't even. It's just fake. It's just crap.
Obviously, if anybody's referring to me as Dr. Mastriani, it's a problem because like, yeah. it happened.
From
so,
now on,
you know, just happened during this meeting or during you know Brian's presentation.
Right. They know I'm presenting.
Mm-hmm.
Any other questions? Yeah.
I have a spreadsheet that I keep on my computer here,
mm-hmm.
and it has all my passwords on.
Mm-hmm.
Is that stupid or what?